So now we're going to look at simplifying rational exponents. Again, remembering that rational just means fractions. Fractions. So really, if you know your exponent laws, these are going to be reasonably straightforward, kind of, sort of. Remember, if I have, thank you, if I have a couple of things like, you know, a cubed times a to the seventh. Remember, you add those and you might get a to the tenth. If I had a to the seventh over a cubed, I would subtract those and get a to the fourth or something like that. If I had a to the second to the fourth, I multiply those together. Something like that. Okay? All right. So you need to be able to use those kinds of tools to do these kinds of problems. So let's do some here. I'll throw some up, and you should try to work them on your own and see if they make sense. And hopefully they do. The doctor's not necessary. So we've got this one. Let's see. And I'll just throw a whole bunch up here right quick. All right, so here they are, as promised. Go ahead and try to work these problems out on your own, again, using the methods that we have up here. Can't quite show them all on the same page. But use those methods using the same exponent laws that you theoretically should have pretty well down by now. Pause the video, go try to work these out, and then come back and see if you got it. Okay, now assuming you've done that, this is going to be b, and remember, when we do this, that means we have to add, we multiply these out. That means we have to add those exponents together. And they're really nice to us right now because they all have the same common denominator. So 6 over 3, just b squared. Not bad, right? Now this is 1 half plus 1 third. So we have to remember how to add fractions. Get a common denominator of 6 times 3, 3 times 2. Something like that. And we can leave it like that since it's just x. There's not a whole lot we can do to make it prettier. This one's just a little bit different because it has that negative sign. But we can go ahead and add those right up. I mean, there's really nothing tricky about that. It's just straight adding. Now this one, we're going to think about subtracting it. So it's 1 third minus 4 thirds. So now this is negative 3 thirds, so it's just negative 1. Now you don't want to leave it like that. 7 to the negative 1 is, remember, 1 over 7 to the first power. The negative means you flip it on the bottom. Of course, 7 to the first power is just 7. That one's kind of tricky. This one here is also kind of tricky, remember, because you've got to apply that 5 to each term. So you have to raise everything in there to the fifth power on the top. So 2 to the 5th, x to the 2 fifths times 5 is just going to be 2, right? 2 fifths times 5, and then negative 5 thirds times 5, I mean negative 1 third times 5 is 5 thirds. And then on the bottom, you just leave it the way it is. Now you'll see the x squareds cancel out. This also is kind of a tricky problem. So 2 to the 5th, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, that's 3, 4, 5, okay. All right, so we have 32. Now with the y's, remember it's y to the 5 thirds, make minus 5 thirds. This has a secret one on the bottom, so since it's on the bottom, we're going to subtract it. 5 thirds minus 1. Y to the 5 thirds minus 5 thirds minus 3 thirds, and we call the denominator. It's minus 8 thirds. This is just a beautiful problem. And since I know that that's a negative exponent, that means that that part goes on the bottom. things. So that's kind of the ugliest answer we got. But that's okay. Her mother still loves them. That's what they're there for. So something like that. See, not so bad, right? Not so bad at all. Okay. Now, a couple of other things we can ask you to do with these. Really are just, you know, like distributing. So really we just want you to be comfortable with everything related to these little fractional exponents. So let me throw these up here. That's a good one. Okay. So I'll work these out with you. Unless you want to pause it, you're certainly welcome to go and work these out in advance and make sure you've got it, but I'll work them out. So remember, we're going to distribute that across. So it's going to be 2/3 plus 1/3, right? And then minus 2/3 plus 5. Okay. 2/3 and 1/3 is 3/3. This other guy, I'm going to have to get a common denominator. Three-thirds is 1. 17/3, that sure isn't pretty, is it? That's okay. No one said it had to be. So, what's going to give me? Remember, z to the first is just z. So you might just write it like this. Pretty? Pretty, right? Okay. This one might also feel a little weird, but it is just going to be the FOIL method. So you've got the first. So this one, and let me just actually write it out like this. First, outer, inner, last. Okay, so on these, I really wouldn't recommend trying to combine them too much that first time. I just go with first, outer, inner, last. All right, so it's going to add those exponents together. Oh, look, these are the same thing. They have the same x to the third. So plus 2 of something, minus 5 of something, would be minus 3 of something. Right, because does that make sense? Because these are the same. Like 2x minus 5x minus 3x. So that works out. And that'll simplify, of course, too. That, which really doesn't look that pretty, but it looks better than that. That looks really scary. That would be your final answer on that one. Good? Let's see, what else can we ask you to do? We might also ask you to do something like factor x to the negative 1/2. Out of some expression. So really, if you see a problem like that, what they're saying is, okay, I want this to equal this. Okay? Now an analog, a similar problem, you know, would be, you know, to say, factor x squared out of, you know, 3x to the fifth minus 7x squared y or something like that. You know, so you say, okay, if I pull the x squared out, you know, who's left out of the first one? 3x cubed, who's left out of the second one? 7y. Okay, so you can do this. So since you can do that, hopefully you can do that. Since you can do that, that means now you can do this problem. So you say, okay, if I factor a negative 1/2, x to the negative 1/2, I should say, out of here, I'm only going to be left with the 3, right? I'm only going to be left with the 3. So the 3 is left there. Now, here's a more complicated question, is if I pull a negative 1/2 out of here, who's going to be left? Well, there'll be a 7 left. But what else is going to have to happen? And this, it's just kind of like, x to the what is going to give me 5 halves. So one way to think about it is to kind of go ahead and distribute it again. So we'd say, okay, x to the negative 1/2 times, I'm not going to really worry about the 7, times x to the what is going to give me x to the 5/2. I remember, oh, I have to add these together. So I need, let me move this guy out of here. So I know that I need minus 1/2 plus something has to give me 5/2. So those would have to be added together. So if I add 1/2 to both sides, that means that whatever that was supposed to be is going to be 6/2. Like, okay, so in theory, I think that's supposed to be 3. But I don't really trust myself, so I'm going to go move this over to the side, and I'm going to check just to be sure. And if I made it more complicated than you need it to be, completely ignore what I said. I'm just going with trying to show you every possible way to think through it. But if you can make it make sense without doing that, you know, definitely go that route. So I'm going to go ahead and distribute. All right, so I have 3 times x to the negative 1/2 minus 7 x to the minus 1/2 x cubed. So that's that. That's that. I need to add these together. So I need a common denominator. And yep, that's the same thing I got. This is the same thing as that. So that means I did it right. So whoo, take a kind of a sigh of relief there. Now, I know it feels like we're doing a ton of these, but there's just really so many different kinds of things that they can ask you to do with these kinds of problems. So another kind of problem would be to say, use rational exponents. Honestly, I think the one we just did is probably the hardest. I might be eating my words here in a second. Use rational exponents to simplify. I think this is just kind of a harken back to what we were doing earlier. Whenever they are asking you to do something like this, they literally just want you to say, oh, that's x to the fourth with the eighth root. And then you're supposed to go, oh, I can simplify that. You know, really, that's all they're asking for is just for you to rewrite it and then simplify whatever that fraction has to be. So sometimes they can make it a little bit more complicated, like the sixth root of 25. In a problem like that, they kind of want you to recognize that 25 is 5 squared, right? Right? Yeah. Okay, we're good. So I could rewrite that as 5 to the 2/6, right? Because it's squared, the 6th root. So we go, oh, look, it's 5 to the 1/3, okay? And this is a nice little trick to be able to use anyway, especially something like this. I really like doing it on those kind of problems. So we have something like, you know, again, just more of an abstract problem. So see if you can get that one. Take a second, pause the video, work it out. Assuming you've done that. So it's a square, but I've taken the 4th power is to the 6th, but I'm taking it with a 4th power. And then you just simplify those fractions. Oops. So that's kind of what they're looking for. Okay. And then the last set, yes, I promise this is the last set. They might say to simplify to 1 radical. And that would be something like, okay, if I have a square root of x times the 4th root of x, you know, what can I do with that? I can say, well, I can say that's x to the 1/2. Times x to the 1/4. And honestly, compared to some of that factoring and simplifying stuff we were doing, this just seems way easier. And again, it's just coming down to finding a common denominator. So that would be 2 fourths plus 1 fourth is x to the 3 fourths. So that's really what they're looking for you to do there. Okay. So see if you can do this one on your own. Okay, pause the video, go see if you can work it out. Assuming you've done that. It's 1/3, so we subtract those, right? Good. So x to the 1/6. Now, about the only other thing they can do to try to trip you up is to actually try to trip you up. So what if instead of having, say, this times the square root of x, what if I change these numbers to, like, 5 and 2? You might say, okay, well, I've got this and I've got this, but I can't do anything else here. And you're done. This is actually done. See the bases? Are not the same, so I can't combine them. Okay, so whenever you get to something like that, if the bases aren't the same, remember you can't combine them. You know, they might be throwing something like that at you just to trick you, kind of mess you up because they're mean and stuff. But it's not so bad. All right, have fun.